Do you need to write a description for your game that will get players interested? Are you wondering what to include in the Steam game description and you aren't quite sure? No worries. In a recent video, I went through all the steps needed to create a Steam page. I didn't have much time to dig deeper into the details in that one, so in this video, let's take a closer look at the different description sections you can have on Steam, and most importantly, what you should write there. Hi, my name is Auro. I'm a full-time indie game developer, creator of Mortal Glory, and currently working on a game called Chambers of Devious Design. On top of that, I also make these weekly YouTube videos sharing my experiences to help you on your own game dev journey. Okay, let's start with the topic and let's first talk about the short description. Here you can use up to 300 characters to describe your game, which will then be shown at the top of your Steam page. You should treat this section as an opportunity to pique the interest of a potential customer. When someone reads your short description, it is likely that they have either heard about your game somewhere or they have just stumbled upon it on Steam and now they want to find out if it's a game they might want to try out. Because of the character limitation, you will need to express your ideas in a very concise format. You don't need to explain what the whole game is about, but just try to give a quick idea what kind of a game it is. If you have an interesting hook in your game, this would be a good place to mention about it. Likewise, if your game has an interesting thematic setting, it's a good idea to bring that up in the short description. The short description is also a good place to make it clear for the reader which genres your game falls into. You don't need to do this, but often players are seeking games from specific genres, so you can help them out by using genre-defining words here like survival or Souls-like. Maybe a good general tip would be to include in the short description whatever you think is the most interesting thing about your game overall, as long as 300 characters is enough to describe it. Also, keep in mind that at this point, the customer is not familiar with your game, so the interesting thing has to be something that the customer can easily understand without any existing knowledge about your game. To you, as a developer, some technical feature might be very interesting, but to a customer who likely doesn't know anything about your game, likely doesn't know anything about game development, and might not be even familiar with other games similar to yours, their reaction to an interesting technical feature is likely just a big, huh? So think about who you are writing the description for. Of course, if you know for a fact that all your customers are likely to be very technical-minded, go ahead and write a really technical description. If you're not sure what the most interesting things about your game are, it might be a good idea to find a few people who you know like games like yours. Get them to try out your game and see what they find the most interesting about your game. Lastly, about the character limit. Rather than using the full 300 characters, I think you should rather aim for something like 200 characters. The shorter your description is, the more likely a potential customer is to actually read the description. But of course, at the same time, the shorter your description is, the harder it is to convey ideas through it. If you plan on localizing your Steam page, it's also good to note that some languages use more characters than others. So if your short description is close to 300 characters in English, you will likely need to make adjustments to it with some languages. Then, let's move on to the long description, which is called About This Game section. My theory is that most customers won't read this section. They might glance at it, maybe read a few words here and there, but they are likely to skip through most of it. If they do read it through, you can expect that they are very interested in your game and just want to know a bit more about it before they make up their mind. Most likely, they are planning on buying it or at least wishlisting it, and now they're just seeking additional information to support their decision. So, with this in mind, I would say that with the long description, you have two objectives. Number one, the primary objective is to convey the key selling points of your game to the majority of the customers who just glance through your text. So basically, just list the most interesting things your game has to offer. Then, number two, the secondary objective is to provide enough relevant information about your game to support a decision to buy for the minority of customers who do read through your text. Let's start with the primary objective. Here the key is providing easily digestible information. You don't want your description to be just a big block of text. To the glancers, a big block of text is the same as an empty description, but just uglier. But luckily, you have a lot of tools on your hands to turn a big block of text into a glance-friendly description. First of all, you can divide your text into small sections to make it more readable. You can use lists to make a collection of things more readable. You can use stylized text, most notably bolded text, to emphasize your key messages. For emphasis, you can also use headers. A long block of text divided into small paragraphs with descriptive headers is already a major improvement to the digestibility of your text. In the long description, you can also use pictures and GIFs to spice up your text. I think this is a very good idea. The impatient customer is more likely to watch a 5-second GIF than read through a small paragraph. If you can easily convey an interesting feature in your game with a short GIF, that's a very efficient and customer-friendly way to convey information about your game. Just try not to overdo it and keep the GIF sizes reasonable. Too many GIFs playing at once can be very distracting, and big GIFs will increase the loading time of your Steam page for those on a bad connection. You can also use the ability to add pictures in a creative way. One common way is to replace your headers with pictures. This lets you freely adjust the size, font, and style of your header, helping it pop up more and making it more likely to be read by a glancer. Another common way to creatively use pictures is to add a custom section separator to add some unique flair to your page. It's not necessary to use pictures like this, but they can help to make your page more presentable to the reader. By using these different tools, you should aim to hammer in the key points about your game to the glancer in as few words as possible. By doing this, you can give the glancer a quick idea what your game is all about without them having to read through your page. As for the secondary objective, which was to provide enough relevant information about your game to support a decision to buy for those who read through most of your texts, I think this objective is easy to accomplish. Basically, you just need to have enough text in the description. Different people like reading different amounts of text, but I think it's generally enough if you just have a short paragraph about each or at least most of your key points. Of course, this can also depend on your audience and genre. Casual puzzle games can probably get away with less details than a grand scale 4X strategy game. But to summarize, I would say you can accomplish both objectives by listing your key points, writing a few details about them, and then making sure you somehow highlight the most interesting bits for the glancers. That should do. There are also optional sections you can add to your Steam page about the long description. These are reviews, awards, and a special announcement section. The reviews and awards are pretty self-explanatory. If your game has gotten some good reviews or awards, it might be a good idea to add a separate mention about them on your page with these sections. The special announcement section is more freeform and you can customize it as you wish. You don't see it used very often, but I think it can be a good place to promote a Discord server for the game, or maybe do some cross-promotion for a sequel to the game, or something like that. You can also customize the visibility based on a country-by-country basis, so this would be a good place to promote a region-specific contest, for example. But hey, that's all I have for this video. I would love to hear if you got something useful out of it. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.